children, how are you all? Hope you all are fine and safe at home. Children, in the last class, I taught you poem 2, Butterfly Laughter. Isn't it, children? So today I am going to teach you the book exercise. Book exercise, and I am going to read the question answers. Understood, children? Okay, we'll see. All, if you have a book, all of you take page number 21. Take page number 21. Okay, children, now see in page number 21, tick the correct meanings of these lines. You have to tick the correct meanings. Understood, children? See, number one, and each morning we tried who should reach the butterfly first. And each morning we tried who should reach the butterfly first. So what is the correct meaning of, for this line? The children tried to catch the butterfly on their porridge bowls. Our second one, the children try to be the first to finish their porridge. Which is the correct meaning, children? This is the correct meaning. The children try to be the first to finish their porridge. So you have to put a tick here. In the B1, you have to put a tick. Understood, children? Okay, we'll turn to the next page. Page number 22. Page number 22. Okay, see, second one. Then the grandmother said, do not eat the poor butterfly. Then the grandmother said, do not eat the poor butterfly. So what is the correct meaning for this sentence? A, the grandmother was afraid the hungry children would eat the butterfly. Or the grandmother joked that the hungry children would eat the butterfly. The second one, okay, the grandmother joked that the hungry children would eat the butterfly. So you have to put a tick here. Understood, children? Okay. Third one, always she said it and always it started as laughing. Always she said it and always it started as laughing. Which is the correct answer? The children laughed because they thought their grandmother was foolish. Or the grandmother laughed because it was a sweet joke between them and their grandmother. Which is the correct answer? The children laughed because it was a sweet little joke between them and their grandmother. So you have to put, for this also tick, you have to tick the B1. Understood? And the fourth one, I was certain that one fine morning, what's the butterfly would fly out of our plates. What's the correct answer, children? One day the butterfly would fall into their porridge plates, or one day the painted butterfly on the plate would come to life. One day the painted butterfly on the plate would come to life. This is the correct answer. Okay, children? So this also you have to put a tick in the B1. Understood? For everything, B is the correct answer. And see, how do you think the poor poet feels about her grandmother? Give reasons is there. You have to make say, no, not this one. See, come to the C1, ma. Use these phrases from the poem in sentences of your own. You have to make sentences on your own. I have given in the notebook. So after completing this book exercise, I will teach you this one. Understood, children? So we'll go to the D. Match these words to form compound words. Compound words means what, children? Compound words means what? When two words are joined together. See, when two words are joined together to make a new word. When two words are joined together to make a new word, it is called a compound word. Understood, children? When two words are joined together to make a new word, it is called compound word. See, example, grand plus mother. Grand plus mother, grandmother. See, these two are separate. When two words makes a new word. These two words made a new word. So that is called grandmother. This is called compound word. Understood, children? So, we'll see some examples. See, butter, rain, down, child, under, run is given. And here, stood, stays, bow, way, hood, fly. So, what's the correct answer will come first one? Butterfly. Butterfly. So, we have written butterfly. Can you see, children? Yes. Okay. Next one.
rain, what will come? Rainbow, rainbow, see, rainbow. These two words combine to form a new word called rainbow. And the third one, downstairs, what will come? Downstairs, D-O-W-N, down, S-T-A-I-R-S, downstairs. And then one, childhood, what will come? Childhood, C-H-I-L-D, child, H-O-O-D, hood, childhood. And the fifth one, understood, what will come? Understood, understood, U-N-D-E-R, under, S-T-O-O-D, understood. And this one, runway, what will come? Runway, R-U-N, run, W-A-Y, runway. Understood, children? These two words that makes a new word is called compound words. Understood? Now we will see the plurals. Plural and the collective nouns. Plurals we will see. Understood, children? See, nouns that stand for one thing. See, nouns that stand for one thing means only single. That means a place, animal or a person are called singular form. Then the singular noun. Understood? Nouns that stand for one thing. Understood? And nouns that stand for more than one. More than one means it is called plural forms. One thing means singular form, and more than one thing, one means what? Plural form. It includes person, place, animal, thing. Understood? See, the first one, for the first one, what to see? Plate. Plate is a singular one. And plates, it is more than one, so it's called plurals. This is singular and this is plural. See, dress, dresses. Understood, Shelly? This is the example for singular and the plural form. And see, in singular and plural, many, see, you can, how to write, we will see here. See, here, you can you see? In words that end with Y, that end with Y, see, example, butterfly. B-U-T-T-E-R-F-L-Y. See, here ends with Y, isn't it? When the word ends with Y, you have to, what you have to, you have to drop the Y. You have to drop the Y. You have to drop the Y and you have to add I-E-S. You have to add I-E-S. See, can you see here? Butter flies. F-L-Y they removed, and instead of Y, what they have added? I-E-S they have added. See, like here, hobby. Instead of this Y, they have added I-E-S. Can you see, children? So, you should be, it's very easy. When Y comes, you have to remove that one and you have to add I-E-S. And then, the next one, in the word that end with F, F-R-F-E, F-R-F-E, plurals are formed by dropping the F-R-F-E and you have to add V-E-S. In this letter, what you have to see here, see, leaf. You have to take that F and you have to add what you have to add? V-E-S, leaves. Leaf, F you have to remove and you have to add V-E-S. And here see, F-E you have to remove and you have to add V-E-S. Leaf, leaves. Wife, wives. Understood, children? And see, another one. Some nouns remain the same in singular and the plural form. In singular also, the same spelling will come, and for the plural also, same. You should not add S or I-E-S or V-E-S. Nothing you should add. The same will come. Example for sheep. Sheep. Sheep only. Understood, children? Sheep means sheep. Deer. Deer. Understood? Only that was. See, scissors. Scissors means here also scissors. Plurals means plural only will come. Understood? Like this, you should be very careful while writing. We'll see some examples. See here, these are all singulars. These are singular. Jeans. Jeans means what you have to write? You have to should write only jeans. Because here, yes, you should not remove anything. Jeans, jeans. Cough. See here, F is coming. So what you have to add, children? V-E-S. You have to add V-E-S. Don't forget. Here also shelf. You have to remove this F and you have to add V-E-S, shelves. Penny. A penny means here you have to remove Y and you have to add what, children? I-E-S, pennies. And here, deer, deer. You should not add, say, D's. That means it will be wrong. Understood? Church. This is easy. You have to add church and you have to put E-S. You have to add E-S. Dish. Dishes. Here also you should add ES. Life. F-E you have to remove and what you have to add? VES. Understood, children? Jeans, jeans. Calf, cows. Shelf, shelves. Penny, pennies. Deer, deer. Church, churches. Dish, dishes. Life, lives. Understood, children? Now we'll see some collective nouns. What are collective nouns, children? What are collective nouns? Nouns that name a group of class of things, people or animals are called collective nouns. A collective noun is always treated as a singular noun. It always singular. It doesn't mean pack my packs of shop. It won't pack pride. Understood? Like that only it will come. So nouns that name a group or class of things, people or animals are called collective noun. See example, a pride of lions. This is called collective noun. A pod of dolphins. Understood? Likewise, we'll see some examples. See some of the examples, words given, you have to choose and write. A pack of wolves, a crowd of people, a troop of soldiers, a school of fish, a gaggle of geese, a choir of singers. Understood, children? Are you thorough? You have to write in pencil neatly. Understood? Now we'll see the new words, the and synonyms and question answers. Okay, children? Okay. See. This new words I have taught you in the last class itself. So I am leaving this one. I am going to the synonyms. Understood, children? Synonyms, I'm going to write the synonyms. Synonyms means what, children? Meanings. Synonyms means what? Meanings. Porridge. Cereal boiled in water or milk. Cereal boiled in water or milk. Perch. Perch means what, children? Sit. Perch means what? Sit. Okay. The third one. Teeniest. Teeniest, smallest. Teeniest, smallest. Pronunciation, teeniest. Understood? Certain, sure. Certain, sure. Lap. Flat pot at the top of the legs. Flat pot at the top of the legs. Okay, now we'll go to the antonyms. Antonyms means what, children? Opposites. Antonyms means opposites. Laugh. Cry. C-R-Y. Cry. Sit. Stand. S-T-A-N-D. Stand. Day. N-I-G-H-T. Night. Morning. Evening. E-V-E-N-I-N-G. Evening. Poor. Rich. R-I-C-H. Rich. Okay. This make the sentence on your own by using these phrases. It's given in page number 22. Page number 22 is given. I told that I will teach you. Understood? See, there are some of the phrases they have given. You have to make not only this sentence, you can write on your own also. Understood, children? But the sentence should be correct. The sentence and the grammatical mistake should not be there. Understood, children? Okay. In the middle, this is the phrase. In the middle is the phrase. You have to make the sentence of on your own. Okay. The butterfly was in the middle. The butterfly was in the middle of the porridge plates. Understood, children? The butterfly was in the middle of the porridge plates. Have you understood, children? This word should be here. This word should be here. Okay. Made us laugh. Made us laugh. So what we can write? The crown's trick made us laugh. The crown's trick made us laugh. Understood? Crowns, when you write, you have to put that apostrophe command. Yes, you have to put. See what made us laugh word is here or not? Phrase is here. Isn't it? Okay, you can write like this also. See, I have written black, blue. Black, blue. And I have left one line. Have you seen? I have left one line. You also write like that, ma, so that it will be very neat. Understood? For that only we are writing like this. To understand only. And the third one, see. Sweet little joke. Sweet little joke. So, sweet little joke. The grandmother cracked a sweet little joke. The grandmother cracked. Cracked means said. Understood? The grandmother cracked a sweet little joke. See, sweet little joke. This phrase is here. Understood? Okay, we'll see the fourth one. grandmother's lap. Grandmother's lap. Hema sat on her grandmother's lap to hear the story. We also will be very eager to hear the story from our grandparents, isn't it? See, Hema sat on her grandmother's lap. See, here is grandmother's lap is here, isn't it? To hear the story. Understood, children? I have given 5 is there, but I have given only 4. Understood? You have to copy down it in the classwork note. Now answer the following. Question answer is not in this lesson, but I have given. Understood, children? So don't say, Miss, question and answer is not in the book. I have given this one on my own. Okay? Okay. What was in the middle of the porridge plates? What was in the middle of the porridge plates? There was a blue butterfly painted in the middle of the porridge plates. There was a blue butterfly painted in the middle of the porridge plates. Understood, children? And the second one. Where did the butterfly perch? Where did the butterfly perch? The butterfly perched on the grandmother's lap. The butterfly perched on the grandmother's lap. Have you understood, children? Where did the butterfly perch? The butterfly perched. ED you have to add. Here only perch is there, but what you have to do? You have to add ED. The butterfly perched on the grandmother's lap. And you have to keep full stop. Many of them, after I am saying that to keep full stop also, many of them are not doing. Keep full stop. Understood, children? Okay, children. I have read everything. See, can you see this one? See, like this, poem 2, butterfly laughter. And then you have to write, say, I forgot to leave one line for this one. So you also don't do that mistake. You have to leave one line and write. Understood, children? New words. See, synonyms, antonyms, make sentences, and then question answers. So write neatly, children. Understood, children? Will you do that one? Okay. We'll meet in the next class. Thank you, children.